I keep on guessing. Mr. McCree's wife's name? Roy. Do you know Mr. McCree's wife's name?
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the 8th regular City of Newton Council meeting for this calendar year. Thank you for being here this evening. Hopefully, we'll get out of here in time to get home and watch the weather for the next day or two. And hopefully, it'll be in our favor. At this time, I'll turn the meeting over to, well, I've got Ms. Danner's opening the meeting this evening, so I'm going to turn the meeting over to her for her opening remarks.
Okay, good evening, everyone. Like Mayor has said, it's good to see each and every one of you this evening. Mayor just asked for me to expound just a little bit on the Southeastern Narrow Gauge and Short Line Museum that we have here in the City of Newton. And there are some little cards out there that you can grab. Chief has them if you don't have one, just to give you a little background knowledge on it. But I'm very passionate about this particular venue we have, I guess, or nonprofit we have in the community, because I'm excited about them being excited. I'm not a train guru, but they are, and I just enjoy the excitement they see in it, and preserving our depot is exciting to me as well. And I just want to give you a little bit of history, if I could now. It says, welcome to the Newton Depot. This is on the website, and it says it's the home of the Southeastern Narrow Gauge and Short Line Museum. Our museum is three-part campus, including the historic 1924 Newton Depot, the Alexander Railroad Pavilion, and the Model Railroad Center. And the Newton Depot was restored from 1997 to 2005, and it features historic railroad artifacts. The Alexander Railroad Pavilion houses full-size rail cars restored by the Alexander chapter of the National Railroad Historical Society. And the Model Railroad Center, it hosts many operating model layouts, and it includes the wage train, town, and the museum's gift shop. All three of these components weave together technology and history about the backdrop of our local heritage here in Newton. It's 4-acre campus, and it's authentic, a Southern Railroad depot. It was built in 1924, and the depot houses our indoor museum. It has offices, and it has rental facilities. As I go monthly to the meetings, I've learned so much about this historic building, and I never thought of it until Mayor had me really sit down and say, okay, I sat down and started looking at some things and wanted to say, there's a pavilion, there's a stage, and where you can have weddings type events. You can have outdoor events there. And it's also on our north side of town. So when you come in from Conover on 16, you'll see it to the left as you come into Newton on that north side. So it has a lot to offer. And I'm excited also that the depot, it has a brick plaza next to the depot housing, and its ironic red caboose on one side, and a narrow gauge flat car is at the end that serves a local stage for concerts or wedding receptions. Behind the caboose, across the tracks from the plaza, is our 1948 former Amtrak dining car, and it's under restoration, which when it's completed, it can be used for catered events, and it's really nice. And if you look at that map on the back, if you have this brochure, the railroad track is in between the property that they own, and that's very unique and interesting to me because that belongs to the railroad, but they can pick up their phone, make a phone call, and you know, and they're able to talk with the ones at the railroad and get things done on those tracks there. And so I was just so amused by that because we as city officials know how hard that could be and getting in contact with them. So we have a gym here in the city. So glad that Mayor asked me just to take a moment when we open up to let you know that visit the museum and check it out, see what's there. You know, tell others about what we have here in the city of Newton. And I will say that they do a lot of events too. There's a railroad expo at the Metro Center that's huge, and they'll be going to Tweetsie Railroad this time too. So our name Newton is all over it, and I'm just excited. And in the magazine, there's also a magazine that they publish. Let me find it for you. It's called the Narrow Gauge and Short Line Gazette. So our name is all over the place everywhere, and it just excites me, and I want you to get excited about it and tell others and let us know we have that here in the city of Newton. So that's all I have, and if we'll stand for a Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Beverly, for that information. It is a nice venue that we have in Newton, and it will at some point in time become a destination here in Newton. So moving on to the approval of our agenda, we do have a couple of items that need to be looked at, and I'm going to turn that over to Mr. Hovis.
Thank you, Mayor. Pages 61 and 63, the budget ordinance amendments to amend the revenues and expenditures are correct, and the line item numbers are correct. It's just the language. It should not be the electric fund. It should be the water and sewer fund on both of those pages. So we are substituting pages 61 and 63 with the correct verbiage.
Do we need to accept that formally, Mr. Selly? A motion, or this is just...
I don't think so. One thing I do want to point out, I think it's fine the way Ms. Travis has said. Okay. One thing I do want to point out real quickly, any non-budget ordinance that's on here tonight, remember it has to pass by a two-thirds majority, okay? Non-budget ordinance that is on consent, it must pass by a two-thirds majority to pass on first reading. I just want to keep that in mind for you, specifically in reference to subsection E, just so you know.
Okay. Very good. We'll get into that under new business then. Okay. So do I have a motion to approve the agenda?
So moved.
I have a motion by Johnson and a second by Sain. And all in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed like sign. And it's approved unanimously. Approval of minutes from the July 9th meeting. Are there any additions, corrections, deletions to the minutes?
Motion to approve is submitted.
I have a motion by Johnson.
Second.
Second by Sain. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed like sign. Motion carries. On into the consent agenda. We have seven items on the consent agenda. And I believe we had, did anyone want to move anything, take anything off of the consent agenda at this time or make any changes?
Motion to approve as is.
I have a motion to approve.
Second.
As, and a second. Any discussion?
Are we going to call for it? I was just going to oppose, but once you call for it.
Okay. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed?
I oppose.
Okay.
And I just want to say I oppose on the agenda E, consideration of amendment to Chapter 1, okay. Section 1 through 6, the City of Newton Code of Ordinances.
Okay. The consent agenda is approved on a 4-1 vote. 4-2.
Wait a minute.
No. 4-1.
You voted against. You voted against all the consent agenda. It's all of one or the other. Because you considered the consent agenda all. Right. That's why I wanted to point out before we got to the consent agenda, in case there was any concern about any item that is not a budgetary ordinance, it has to pass by two-thirds vote on first reading.
Right.
So if we have a 1-2, 3-2 vote, then it passes, but that item will have to be on the agenda again for next month for a second vote, and a simple majority that time will pass it.
Okay.
Thank you. So all that happened is that item, it can be on consent agenda again.
Which item will we take?
As long as it passes.
It's E.
We're removing E.
The ordinance.
All right, it'll pass next month.
Okay. Yeah.
So we'll move forward with this agenda.
Yes.
With this agenda, yeah. And then it'll be on the in our next meeting.
Just that one.
In September.
Just that one item.
Thank you for that clarification, Mr. Silly. Appreciate that.
E. Subsection E.
All right. Moving on to new business. We have a consideration for voluntary annexation, and I believe Mr. Alex Fulbright's going to share information with us. Good evening, Alex.
Good evening. Thank you, Mayor, members of council. You have before you a petition of contiguous annexation for D&D Development and Construction, LLC. This is the property that many of you may know as Buffalo Ridge. They're seeking to annex property located off of Smyre Farm Road, and it's 38 acres, a little bit more. And it's the development, when complete, will consist of 124 single-family homes, and this was approved the City Council in February of 2023. The project is currently under development, under construction. If you've been out there, they've moved a lot of dirt. They built a lot of retaining walls, and they put in a lot of sewer and stormwater. The request for tonight, this is one of two parts. That's the way the annexations work. So tonight, you'll be asked to adopt a resolution directing the city clerk to investigate the petition, receive this clerk's certification of sufficiency, which is attached, and adopt a resolution fixing the date of the public hearing. The suggested date for the public hearing is the next meeting, which is September 3rd, and that will be advertised in the O&E as required. So if you have any questions, I'll be more than happy to answer those.
Is it three, or is it just one? We adopt this.
He's asking for three motions or one.
Yeah, to be three, to be safe, three, yes, sir.
Okay, this and this is this is a consideration to call and set the date. This is not a public hearing, but it's for to set the date. So, do I have a motion? And do we need to make this motion as he prescribed?
Yeah, as it's set out.
Okay.
There, yes.
All right.
Okay.
Mr. Dixon.
Motion to adopt a resolution directing the city court to investigate the petition.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, like sign.
Motion to receive the clerk's certification to sufficiency.
Second.
Have a motion and a second by Johnson. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Like sign. All right. And number three?
Motion to adopt a resolution fixing the date of public hearing on the question of annexation.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Motion. By Dixon, second by Johnson, and that is all three of those items. And the
we've got to vote on that.
Then we're going to vote. We got to vote on that. So all in favor,
say aye.
All opposed. Motion carries.
Thank you.
All three items have passed. And this time, the public hearing for will be at 6 p.m. on September the 3rd. Here in the chambers of the City Hall. All right, item B is a consideration of budget ordinance amendment for the purchase of materials for electric system extension in Buffalo Ridge Development. And Dusty, our Public Utilities Director, is going to take us through this. Dusty, you get three parts tonight.
Our common groups. Mayor, Council, good evening.
Good evening.
This is a pretty standard request. I've asked it before. We are going to attempt to extend the electrical distribution system into the Buffalo Ridge residential subdevelopment. We've done this many times in the past. This is the one that's off of Smyre Farm Road. Work will include about 11,500 feet of underground electrical distribution line and about 24 pad-mounted transformers of various capacity. Our consultant has almost completed the engineering drawing, so that is, as my understanding, is done, actually, as of yesterday. And the total estimated cost for materials is $295,000. which of course was not budgeted for in the fiscal year budget. So we asked that council approve the attached budget ordinance amendment, which was one of, no, this was the one that was right. The next two were the ones that were wrong. Sorry about that, guys. That's on me.
No.
The we think that all the materials, with the exception of the transformers will take about 8 weeks, and the transformers have a lead time of 25 weeks. And that sounds like a lot, but it's a lot better than 100 weeks, so we're happy. In the meantime, if we need to get cracking, we do have a, I don't really want to call it an inventory, because then finance gets upset, but we have a supply of transformers dedicated to residential developments that we can draw on until those transformers start coming in. So 8, maybe 9 weeks, and we'll think we'll be ready to rock. And of course, all the construction will be done by guys on the electric crew. So I'll be happy to answer any questions.
Do we get reimbursed for these?
No. The electric system pays for the cost of construction over the lifetime of the installed infrastructure. So no, we do not ask for reimbursement on the electric system.
So is there a return on investment by taxes that we charge the residents and things like this, or
the electric rates? And also, please keep in mind that we do not have a monopoly on electrical service providers in the area. Duke can come in, and Duke also provides all of their extensions at no cost.
Any further questions? We have a motion to approve.
Motion to approve the attached budget ordinance amendment to provide funding for the Buffalo Ridge Electrical Distribution System Extension.
We have a second.
Second.
Motion by Dixon, second by Sane. Any discussion? Further discussion? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, like sign. Motion carries unanimously. Next item on the agenda is item number C, consideration of a budget ordinance amendment for a bar screen repair at the wastewater treatment plant. And you're going to explain what a bar screen is.
Sure. You know the strainer that's in your kitchen sink that catches all the food? That's the bar screen.
Thank you.
Ours is broke. That is the first piece of equipment between the sewer collection system and the actual plant itself. It's before the influent pump station and everything. It removes major debris, big solids, rocks, mop heads, comforters, blankets, uniforms, animal parts, you name it, it comes up through the bar screen. This is done to, number one, optimize flow, hydraulic flow through the plant. Number two, prevent wear and tear and damage to the pumps. As you know, we've had some issues with those pumps in that pump station a couple years back anyway. Ideally, that equipment should operate between 24 and 48 times a day and should do so automatically with no operator input. The bar screen has not operated automatically for several years. The operators have been operating, as they say, in hand, because the instrumentation is both the original 1976 instrumentation and non-functioning. The bar screen is part of the rehab of the sewer plant, and my staff and I have literally done everything we are allowed to do by law to keep it up and running, but it has reached a point where we can do no more and can get no parts without a complete rehab. So what we're asking for tonight is $27,500 to do some minimal repairs on the bar screen. This will not repair the instrumentation. It will still have to be operated in hand by the operators. But hopefully we will have the replacement in place in 24 to maybe 36 months. I'll be happy to answer any questions.
Reduces overflow and disruption in the operation, basically. And
a lot of this is those we have experienced in the last 8 months.
Yeah.
This is part of the problem.
Yeah.
If the plant's in bad shape, there's a lot of problems. This is part of it. The last one we experienced was caused by the bar screens not operating.
This was installed in 1974. This is 2024.
The biggest parts of it was. Now, some of the wear and tear items on the bar screen have been replaced, but it is a 1974 model.
This is a fund balance request for replacing that. So, okay, do I have a motion?
I'll make the motion to approve the budget ordinance amendment for the bar screen repair at the wastewater treatment plant.
Motion by Sane, second by Johnson. Any discussion? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, like sign. Motion carries unanimously. The next item on the agenda is item D, consideration of budget ordinance amendment for a check valve replacement at the wastewater treatment plant. Dusty, you can take us through that one too, aren't you?
Yeah. Okay, so back at the sewer plant again. On the tertiary filter backwash pump, there is a check valve. This valve prevents the backwashed material sludge from traveling in the wrong direction and moving against the pump and again against the hydraulics of the plant. We have spent some money and gotten, I believe it was Kemp out there to take a look at it and try to replace the mechanical parts inside the valve, but the issue is due to a worn valve body, and it can't be, we can't replace the parts inside the body even if we found them, because the inside of the valve body is so worn that it won't hold them anymore. So we have got an estimate for a complete replacement in the amount of $45,000. That's a lot of money. Keep in mind that at least half of this is dealing with the backwash sludge as it comes out while the check valve is down, because we're gonna take a piece of the pipe out and we can't cut off the backwash pump. So we've got to do something with all that material and for the labor to do that. It's in a, I don't want to say it's a confined space, but it is in a restricted area, and this is a very large valve. It's very heavy, and it's going to have to be moved mainly by hand to get in place. Lead time on the materials is estimated to be 18 weeks. Failure to replace the check valve could result in failure of the pump, which is expensive but not a huge deal, and also the filters, which now the state's going to go, and want to come talk to us. So again, staff recommends council approve the attached budget ordinance amendment. I'll be happy to answer any questions.
Is this a temporary fix, or will this go on to the next phase of the water treatment plant?
We are going to do our best to save it. We have asked the manufacturer of the replacement rehab design if the check valve we are putting in is compatible with the pump on the backwash filter that they are going to put in. I don't have that answer yet.
So this is a part that was installed in 1976, so this is a newer piece that we have there. It's newer than 1974.
You and I have different perspectives on time, for
sure. Yes, we do. I'm afraid so, Dusty.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dusty.
Motion to approve the attached budget ordinance amendment to provide funding for the wastewater treatment plant check valve replacement.
Second. I have a motion to approve.
Second.
And a second by saying, any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, like sign. Motion carries unanimously.
Isn't that a Dusty show in a while?
We had a showing at the last meeting, but
yeah, but
yeah, not like this. Okay, the next item on the agenda, item number 7, are comments from the public. If you'd like to make a public comment on a non-agenda item, we'd love for you to do that. All public comments, are including public hearings, will be limited to 3 minutes. Do we have anyone who would like to come forward at this time with any questions, comments? Hearing none, we'll move on to item number 8, City Manager's Report, Mr. Sean Harris.
Hovis. Well, we went from Todd to Sean, and now we've gone from Hovis to Harris.
All right. Thank you, Mayor. Meetings and events. Music on Main series, we have Gump Fiction Thursday, September 12th from 6 to 8:30. Trial by Fire, Thursday, October 10th from 6 to 8:30. Also a reminder that the 135th Soldiers Reunion begins this Saturday, August 10th. It goes through Thursday, different events each night. We have the Carolina Makers Market, Saturday, September 28th from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. in downtown. City offices will be closed on September 2nd in observance of Labor Day. Also, an update on the West Side JC Lighting. Musco has submitted the application to the to Catawba County for permits. We anticipate material delivery the week of Labor Day. Is that correct? There'll be at least two tractor trailers sitting out there staying overnight, or once they pull in, they don't leave till the job's done. So you're going to see several trucks parked out there at Westside JC. So the permit process through the county is at least a minimum of 10 days or a maximum of 10 days. So once they get the permits, the materials start being shipped here. So you'll start seeing something happening out there very soon.
Good. Sounds good.
Brandon's going to provide your streetscape update since Mr. Williams is out of town today.
Brandon Holland.
Brandon Holland, yes. Not Elmwood, I'm sorry.
Thank you, Mr. Manager. Mayor, Council, just a couple of updates for you on streetscape. The underground work has been complete, the underground utility work, and as a reminder, that work takes 4 to 5 times longer than other types of utility work. So we appreciate everybody's patience during this time. New water services have been installed, all except one, and that one will be installed, once the sidewalk work begins. So that's at a different location, and so once the sidewalk starts, that that utility will be hooked up, and so we'll be dealing with utilities in that section. The rain has held up the compaction for the road base, so that's why the road base is still just a little bit behind. The sidewalk from A Street to South B Street has been demolished, and drive-through entrance for First Citizens Bank has been retained. The new curb line has been set, and the curb will be laid as soon as possible, depending on the weather. And so we're just still, you know, waiting on that, and that depends on the compaction as well. Site cleanup for Reunion is going to be Thursday and Friday. And also, as a reminder, there will be no work during Reunion next week. And sidewalk removal in front of the businesses won't happen until after Reunion. And we anticipate moving on to First Street in late September. Does anybody have any questions?
So there will be no construction trucks, vehicles?
Correct.
Such out there. And are they going to clean up what they
yes
that
yes,
area
we've got that for them to clean up, and we're going to be on top of it, making sure it's presentable and up to our standards for Reunion.
Okay.
Yes,
thank
sir.
You
thank you.
Any questions? Thank you, Brandon.
Thank you.
Mayor, Council, that's the end of my city manager's report.
Thank you, Mr. Hovis. Appreciate that. We have questions and comments from the mayor and the council at this time, and we have Mr. Jody Dixon giving us an update on some of the outside boards that he participates on, and after which I will ask Mr. Shane to update us on a few items as well. We've got a lot going on.
We do have a lot going on. First board I'm going to talk about here is the DNDA, the Downtown Newton Development Association. The Main Street turned in economic impact numbers to the state and again received national accreditation for 2024. We're one of 72 accredited Main Streets in the state. Four business owners traveled to Morganton for a full day of training with John Schallert at Main Street Training on how to build a destination business. Music on Main, I think City Manager Hovis mentioned this earlier, that we've got Gump Fiction on September 12th, and Carolina's Makers Market coming on September 28th. We also had a really nice story done by Our State Magazine. You can look online, highlighting a number of Newton downtown businesses. And then DNDA continues to assist businesses working to redesign their storefront by providing facade grants. We gave out another facade grant at the last meeting, which means we've given out, I think, 3 this year already. So that's good stuff. The other board that I sit on is the Public Art Commission. We have not had a meeting lately. I assume that we are going to be back meeting very quickly, though, because we've got another mural that we're going to attempt to do here real soon. We also have the Pixel Sticks. That's right. I was going to say, okay, Pixel Sticks, which is going to be really cool, where you can look at the murals and other public art and things like that. Hold your camera up. It'll tell you a story and things like that about what's going on there with the murals and some of the sculptures and things like that going on. And there was one other thing I was going to talk about. Yes. What have they called? Utility boxes. Yes, we're going to wrap. Have we got the permission for that now? Okay, so the little silver boxes that you see kind of at the stoplights and traffic lights and things like that, those are going to be wrapped in some very cool artwork here coming soon. And I think I used the word groovy last time, so I'll say they'll be groovy this time too. That's my report.
Thank you, Jody. Moving right along, Mr. Singh there.
Thank you, Mr. Dixon. I have a report on the four boards that I serve on. I serve on the corner table board. We had an event Saturday at the fairgrounds where it was a book bag and food giveaway. The corner table gave away 1,200 bags of food over there on Saturday, and there were many people were lined up from the fence all the way back to 70 waiting in line to get in this thing. It was a huge crowd. We also had a board meeting today. The Parade of Cans is going on through the month of August. Plans for the Hunger Walk. That will benefit the corner table, Assure Ministry, and Hickory Soup Kitchen. They'll all split that in thirds. The next board I was recently appointed to is the library board. And this program's over there. They're ending up their summer reading program. And right now, they have programs going on from children to teens to adults, the summer reading program ending. And on August the 10th at 12 o'clock, at the fall gardening will take place at the garden behind the library. I also serve on the Appearance Commission. And we had Yard of the Month for June was presented to Brian and Missy Cleveland from West 7th Street. And I really hate that Mr. McCree isn't here tonight because he and his wife were Yard of the Month for July in Kensington Circle in Startown. Mm-hmm. And we have a meeting on Thursday night, and we will be voting on August Yards of the Month. And in the meantime, we're going around to all the welcome to sites to the city and cleaning them and taking them care of them. And that August Yard of the Month will be the final one for this season. My last committee is the Rec Department. We have had from July the 4th through August the 2nd, we have had 1,532 people at the swimming pool. We have 552 people at the splash pad. We also have, for the month of August, I have a calendar for the month, and as you can see, there's a lot going on at the rec department in the month of August. We have kids' swimming lessons are beginning August the 5th through August the 9th. They're from 6 o'clock to 7:15. It's $40 per child, ages from 6 to 9. We have 8 pool parties booked for the month of August and 4 splash pad parties booked for the month of August. On Friday the 9th, the adult and splash pad Olympics will take place from 10 until 6. On Saturday, August the 10th, the Youth Olympics will take place at the splash pad. The Catawba Valley Hornets will be playing football. We have them scheduled for August the 3rd. Saturday was the Gorillas, and then we play the Ducks on the 24th. They do their, they also play their games at Westside JC Park, but they do their practicing at East Newton on that field. The National Trails Day is August the 17th, 10:30 on the greenways behind the animal shelters where you'll park, and it's a 3-mile walk. On the 17th, we have a Medicare representative at the East Newton Gym. It will be discussing all the changes in Medicare that take place in July. And the lady that's doing that is going to give away school supplies for kids. That will be from 11 until 4 on the 17th. The Catawba County on Aging is holding a seniors dance from 6 to 9 in the lower level of the rec. All these events that I'm mentioning, if you go out into the vestibule, there's a rack there, and it has all these things listed. If you want any of this information, help yourself to it. It's all there. Like I said, the month of August is really full of things, activities. Pet Mania is going to be on August 15th at the lower level of the rec department, sponsored by Conover Veterinary Hospital. 7 categories. There are sign-ups for fall football, flag, youth, and if I'm not mistaken, is there not an adult flag football sign-up? We have an adult flag football, so all you older people want to play a little flag football, come on over and sign up. Mr. Mayor?
You're going to be the quarterback, aren't you?
Yes, sir.
That's right.
So, Mr. Mayor, and that's all I have.
That's all?
Yep.
I see a lot of injuries.
Ed, thank you so much. Jody, thank you so much. Beverly, thank you again for what you have going on. And we'll have reports from our other council members at future meetings, and there's a lot going on there. So this time, let me ask if anyone else has any comments or thoughts you'd like to share.
August 15th is the community meeting on South Urban.
August 15th, Thursday.
5:30, Thursday.
Okay.
5:30.
I do have a comment. John?
If we don't have these slots in place, are we going? Do we have a backup plan for the minor league football team somewhere else for them to play?
We have discussed. I've discussed with them different options available. They have talked to the other teams, but they should be up and running. My staff assured me that they'll work with their schedule.
Very good. Thank you.
My super just came in. I announced it for you. Community meeting. Were you in here? The community meeting, 5:30?
Yes.
On Urban, Thursday? Okay, the 15th.
All right.
Mr. Mayor, one final comment. I'd be remiss if I did not tell you that I wish my wife tomorrow a happy birthday.
There you go.
Well,
happy
birthday to Miss Wendy. Happy birthday. Yep. Okay. Closed session. If there's nothing else at this time, we do have a closed session on our agenda this evening. Under the North Carolina General Statute 143-318-11-5. And we'll go into closed session at this time. We will convene in an office behind the dais here, and we will reconvene after that that meeting has been concluded.
Okay. We need a motion, second, and
a vote. So we need a motion to go into closed session.
So motion.
Second. Have a motion and a second to go into closed session. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Okay.
Thank y'all for coming. If you're not.
Come out of closed session, resume meeting.
Motion to come out of closed session.
Second.
Motion and second, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
All right, passes unanimously.
Motion to adjourn.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All right, see you in September.